Hey, this is Mike. Thank you so much for choosing this video. Tonight, we're checking out a 2022 Hyundai Kona N at night. So this video focuses on the interior and exterior lighting of the vehicle. Check my channel for the full overview. This is a separate video. So first, I want to point out that when you turn the headlight switch to the complete off position, you still have these exterior lights on, these LED strips here in the front, which are quite bright. So now I have the parking lights on, and those real bright LED strips are now dimmer here in the front. You see they're much dimmer, but also there's an amber side marker that illuminates now. So you can see that it's quite bright. It's just a single point, but it is pretty bright, especially when you're looking at it from the side here. The tail lights are now on, and it's a red tail light, and looks like an LED, soft glow LED. And then you have the tag lights there that are illuminating the ground a little bit. Now the camera makes it look a little bit orangey, but they are red in color. So the turn signal indicator is basically a portion of that LED white strip that's at the top, just changed to amber. So you can see it, there's like a little section right there that's still white, and then the rest of it, and that also, when it blinks, turns into a very bright amber color light. So you can see it from the front and the side very easily. There's also a side marker, amber, turn signal indicator here on the side mirror. It's visible from the front, the side, and the back. And the turn signal here in the back is an amber, which is good. I like to see that, an amber, and it's an amber light. This LED is very bright, and it's separated from the taillights. But it is in a very low position. Not a super low, but it is a little bit lower. But the fact that it's super bright and you have that side marker there on the side mirror helps out a lot, making sure other drivers can see it. But it is very bright. Now, everything back here is LED except for the reverse light. So I'm surprised they decided to go with a regular bulb for the reverse lights. So we're gonna look at this going down the road, but there's the low beams. So right here, you can see it casts some light on the ground when you turn the headlights completely off. Parking, there's the headlights on. So the low beams, there's the high beams. But we'll start off with the low beams, and it's a multi-reflector system. So you see there's the outer two reflectors are now illuminated. Let me turn the brightness down so we can see in there a little bit better. So it has a pretty low cutoff, especially close up to the vehicle like this. Let's see here, let's go back a little bit further. Yeah, right in there, it's only like 2 feet off the ground. There's a cutoff here. So it's a multi-reflector. The outer two are the low beams, and then there's the inner one that's your high beams. Now I have the high beams on, and you can see as I dip down, they are all worked together for the high beams. And you see that's the inner portion is now illuminated. So I have the brightness turned up quite a bit because the cargo area appears to be completely dark. And I searched in here for a light, and there appears to be a lens right in here. So to the left, it looks like there's a lens there. I don't know if it's defective, the bulbs went out, or whatever. But even if it did turn on, it seems to, even if that is a lens, I'm not sure what it is, but it would only illuminate this left side, because the right side doesn't have any lights. So for one thing, it's not turning on, and even if it did, it would be pretty inadequate. So the cargo space in this vehicle has very poor lighting, apparently. It's not even working, and even if it did work, it wouldn't be adequate. Because one of the things about having a light on one side and not the other is that you would, whatever you put back here is going to cast a shadow to the right. So, you know, it's just going to, it's not going to be, you're not going to have, if you had, you're not going to have like evenly lit things. So if you put anything tall on the left side, it's just going to cast a shadow on everything on the right. So you only have light on one side, which is not good. The inside of the back door is completely dark, no lights whatsoever. So we have a pocket there that's dark, pocket there that's dark. Even the controls for the light switch is dark, which is surprising. And the back seat is, you have a dome light there in the center, which you can turn off manually, or you can turn it on manually. But that's it, and it's just a standard halogen bulb, so it's not really illuminating this black interior very well, for one thing. It does give you some light, but it's inadequate in my mind. There is a backlit illuminated USB charge port back here on the back of the console, though. The inside of the front door is almost completely dark. It does have some backlit buttons, which is nice, unlike the back door. So there's pockets here. Let me turn the brightness down on the finger pointer. So there's a pocket there that's dark, but then right in here, there's some backlit buttons, but the side mirror adjustments are not backlit. And the interior lights here on the front is provided by these two dome lights, and they are halogen bulbs as well, just like the back one. And it does a, I would say, halfway decent job. It could be a little bit better, but it does have floorboard illumination, which is nice. Glad to see that. So I'm sitting inside with the door open. Let me go ahead and shut that so you can see the interior lights here. All right, so now we're left with the backlit buttons here. See the ones in the door, here to the left of the steering column. On the steering wheel itself, even the little N buttons are illuminated. And here is, things are a little bit brighter because I have the camera turned up quite a bit. But let me turn that down a little bit so you can see, so it's not blasting the camera out. I have it really high because there's some spots in the vehicle that are dark, it's hard to tell. Also, the floorboard illumination, which is really nice in person, but the camera has trouble picking it up with the black carpeting. So so that's a nice touch, having the floorboard illuminated like that. And there's the screen. The camera is decent. You see the backlit buttons here. There's a little storage area, or the wireless cell phone charger. That's dark. So let me turn the interior lights on, maybe you can see what I'm talking about. So that area is dark. There is some little lights here in the cup holders, which is pretty cool. Kind of illuminates the cups or bottles that you put in, just slightly, just on the ends. The center console is dark, just completely. Can't see anything, so I turn on the interior light so you can see. Glove compartment does have a light, which is nice. Now in the settings here, on the screen, is, let's go to I'll go to setup, and then we'll go to vehicle, and then we'll go to lights, and it has a headlight delay, but it also has high beam assist. And basically, when you turn that on or off, it's basically showing that side of the road is a little bit lower. Now, typically, you wouldn't have your high beams on when there's a car right there, so I'm not sure what the purpose of that is. You know, maybe we can find out when we're going down the road, but it says it reduces the high beam glare, which affects drivers in oncoming vehicles. But if, you know, if there's an oncoming vehicle, you wouldn't have your high beams on, so I'm not sure what that's it. We'll leave it on and see what happens. Let's try the brightness here. So when you adjust the brightness, it adjusts not only the gauges, but all the lights here as well. So you can see all the little backlit buttons and the screen and all that stuff, both screens. So that's the lowest, and then there's the highest. So you can see the range there that the button here to the left of the steering column the brightness changes there. So I'm not seeing much of a difference here on the high beams assist. When I put the high beams on and I turn on the high beam assist, or if I put low beams on and I toggle it on and off, I don't really see a difference, but I'm sure it does something. I'm not able to really tell a difference just by looking, but we'll leave it on. You know, maybe it'll help. This vehicle does have automatic high beams as well. So Hyundai does a pretty good job with their automatic high beams, but we'll see if we can leave them on. Some vehicles seem fine, but then they start flashing at the drivers and have to turn them off. Okay, so far we still have the low beams on. Toggling the high beam assist on or off to try to see if we can tell the difference here. Because most vehicles do have on the low beams, they cut off this a little bit lower on the oncoming side. But you know, I don't think that's what it's referring to. It has something to do with high beams, apparently. But like I said, you're not going to be having high beams on when there's a car right there in front of your face. So, very strange. Okay, so the high beam's just turned on now that there's no cars in front of us. And it's looking pretty good. It's looking real nice. Now we can toggle the high beam assist. Yeah, I do see a difference there. Okay, high beam assist is toggling the automatic high beams on and off. That's what it is, instead of just saying, yeah. That's what that is. So when I turn it off, it automatically turned off the automatic high beams. All right. So yeah, it's looking pretty good. I can see the trees in the distance. It's a little patchy here and there with the light on the road, which it's multiple reflector LEDs kind of overlapping. So kind of makes sense, but it does give a good distance, and off to the sides it's illuminated well. And I think these are good. I mean, for the height, the actual height of the headlights are kind of low to the ground, so that's one thing to consider with the distance and, you know, things on the road or things on the side of the road that are short, like tall grass and stuff, will cast shadows behind it since we're so low to the ground as far as the actual headlights themselves. But other than that, we're good, and the automatic high beams so far are working okay.